Honorable Chairman, sir.
Fine.
Vanakkam. Thank you for the opportunity. I rise to oppose the Union Budget 2020-21. For any government, budget is the pivotal key and it should be based on the poll promises made to the people. But this BJP government is anti-people and pro-corporate. They have thrown away all the promises to the wind and came out with a zero budget. I'd like to remind the Finance Minister, through you, sir, about the tall promises made by our Honorable Prime Minister. As it seems, you all have selective amnesia. You promised 2 crore jobs per year. What happened to that? You promised to double the farmer income. What happened? You promised to bring back all the black money and deposit 15 lakhs rupees in each Indian accounts. We are still waiting. What happened? You have promised safety and empowerment of women. What is happening now? Where are the promised Achedin? Look at what you have delivered. Instead of delivering your promise of 2 crore jobs, that means 12 crore jobs by now, you have delivered the highest rate of unemployment in 45 years of India's history. In Tamil Nadu, there are highly educated 14 lakh people had applied for 10 sweeper jobs. Despite this grave situation of unemployment, I shocked to see that the Finance Minister have not uttered the word unemployment even once in his longest ever 2 hours 40 minutes budget speech. The future of millions of youth at stake, it's paining me, but this is not bothering you. This government had single-handedly destroyed the MSME industries, which is the major source of employment. I am coming from the constituency of Karur, which is the fourth largest export in the country. We had a glorious past, but the disastrous decisions of demonetization and hastily implemented flawed GST has destroyed the backbone of the small businesses and industries. I have seen the pain in every day in my life. But this budget hasn't come up with any concrete measures, innovative solutions to revive the MSME sector and boost the economy. So I appreciate that they come with one line solution, which is to increase the audit limit from 1 crore to 5 crores. You promised to double the farmers' incomes, but there have been mass suicides of farmers. You have not waived the farmers' loans to the distressed farmers. I know that this is not the only solution, but this will give the farmers that they are not left alone. The government is with them. That's what UPA government did with the motherly heart, waived 75,000 crores of loan along with some constructive measures. You boast of PM Kisan scheme, but you have not actually spent the 20,000 crore rupees that had been budgeted in 2018 and 2019. Adding woes to the agriculture crisis, there is a delay in payment of Manrega wages for last 6 months in many states, including Tamil Nadu. The senior citizens, women and differently abled, were in tears when I met them in my constituency for not getting their wages for months. This is inhuman, the least I can say. Still, the budgetary allocation of Manrega has been reduced to 9,500 crores. Every day, we the women are facing heinous crimes, rape, and we are battling for our safety. Still, every time the Prime Minister, which is always vocal in Twitter, like social media platform like Twitter, is silent. Unfortunately, the Nirbhaya fund neither increased nor adequately spent. This shows the callous attitude of this government towards women's safety. I'd like to know from this government how much of funds from Save the Daughter, Save the Education scheme were used for our advertisement of our Honorable PM. The PM used to make a big show of for bringing back black money. Now he doesn't even talk about it. Instead, this government promotes the fair and lovely scheme of electoral funds, which get credited whooping 2,410 crore rupees to the BJP account, while the common man is suffering due to lack of income. Sir, I'm coming to my conclusion. Instead of taking this country towards the growth path, this government going astray with the divisive acts like CAA, NRC and NPA. This is not the first time some government is giving asylum to the refugees of many prosecution. Congress government has been given ages, but we haven't discriminated anybody based on religious, race and the country. We are opposing this government discriminate against Muslims and the Sri Lankan Tamils. The Sri Lankan Tamils, there are two generations of youth born and brought up here. When you say the minorities, the other religious, seven religion which you mentioned, brought prosecuted in neighboring countries, only three neighboring countries, we have seven neighboring countries, are not eligible to get the citizenship, what the Tamil people has done to you, why you are discriminating Sri Lankan Tamil in this law, then there is a census due into in this year. This will give all the necessary data for the government. And there is an Aadhaar and voter ID, numerous other identities. Then why you need an NRC? This creates a species in the people's mind. These acts have caused a lot of social unrest. We've been calling from the people from the government, Goli Marago. We can't raise the unemployment youth temper to create violence. This is not go down well with this any economy or anything. This social unrest will further adversely affect the economy. I'd like to end my speech with an apt Thirukural by our great Tamil poet Thiruvalluvar. Of late, the Treasury benches has developed a lot of love for Thiruvalluvar. Though the Prime Minister is from Tamil Nadu, we are getting only Thirukural, nothing else. Ikalikki edesaidal akkam, adanai mihalukin ukumam kedu, meaning shrinking away from hatred will yield wealth. Indulging in increase of it will hasten ruin. I stand opposed the budget. Thank you.